Now, so this is fi of t equal to omega I t by 2 pi. Okay, fi of t by 2 pi. Obviously, so fi of t is what? Instantaneous frequency. What is omega I t? Instantaneous angular frequency. Just like fi and omega. What is omega? 2 pi f, correct? So, yeah. Now, this is what? Is a table which gives you a relation between theta of t and fm and pm in the same way fi of t. Okay, what is omega t? You got omega t k is nothing but omega c plus kp m dash of t. Okay, what is fi of t? Divided by 2 pi, which means fc plus kp m dash of t by 2 pi. Fc plus kp m dash of t by 2 pi. Same thing you can do for fm. So this table is very, very important. Okay, obviously in fm the instantaneous angular frequency is proportional to m of t. In pm it is proportional to derivative of m of t. Okay, now this is a simple table. If you know this table, you know everything. Okay, that is very, very important, correct? So in the last class I told you they are very, very similar. The only difference they have is here m of t, here integration of m of t. Okay, now now we have seen how to generate fm signal by using pm modulator and vice versa. Okay, which means you need only one modulator. Okay, using that modulator you can generate both signals. Okay, if you have fm modulator, from this you can also generate pm wave, and reverse can also happen. If you have PM modulator, you can generate FM also. Okay, so yeah, so maximum frequency deviation. Okay, now here, so maximum frequency deviation. Okay, so after all, what is that maximum frequency deviation means? So in FM, what is changing? Frequency. The frequency of the carrier is changing according to the message signal. Okay, now here. So what is fc? The carrier frequency. Okay, without modulation this is the frequency of the carrier, fc. Okay, if you modulate, obviously the frequency will vary. How much it vary? It will vary. It can go up to this maximum or it can go to minimum also. Okay, so the carrier varies between these two, maximum to minimum. Okay, now here this is called a swing. So it is called a carrier swing. This is called carrier swing. Okay, but what is the frequency deviation means? It is a deviation with respect to fc, carrier frequency, which means from this carrier frequency how much is the deviation. Okay, so from this carrier frequency it can go up to maximum or it can go to minimum. Okay, this is called a deviation. This is a deviation. Deviation means the amount of difference from the center frequency to the maximum or to the minimum. Is it okay? So without modulation your carrier is having fc frequency. If you modulate it will vary. Okay, so it may vary between these two values. Okay, but how much it is deviating from the center line. So this is the amount of deviation or this amount of deviation. Okay, so we take this as a definition of deviation of carrier frequency. That is called peak frequency deviation or maximum frequency deviation. Okay, now how to find out? Obviously, so let me take fi of t. So this is what the equation of fi of t for fm. This for fm. For pm, what is the equation of fi of t? Fc plus kp by 2 pi m of t. Okay, now so here okay, yeah, here it should be m dash of t, correct? Right, m dash of t. Now here So what is delta f? It is nothing but the peak frequency deviation or maximum frequency deviation. It is nothing but what is the difference? Fi of t minus fc, maximum. So now if you find out fi of t minus fc, what do you get? Fi of t minus fc in case of fm is what? Kf by 2 pi m of t. In case of pm, kp by 2 pi m dash of t. So what do you get? Same thing, maximum of m of t kf by 2 pi. In pm, kp by 2 pi maximum of m dash of t. This is what the table which gives you the formula of maximum frequency deviation in case of fm and pm. So you don't get confused, you go with the basic definitions. Is it okay? Right? So if m of t happen to be a sinusoidal signal, we call it as a single tone signal. What happens? If m of t equal to am cos 2 pi fm t, obviously what is delta f? What is delta p for fm and pm? So if m of t is cos function, what is mod of m of t? Am bro, mod of m of t is am. Is it okay? So what is mod of m dash of t? Anyone? What is mod of m dash of t? Who will tell the answer? If m of t equal to am cos omega m, what is mod of m of t? Maximum. Obviously, am. What is m dash of t? Minus omega m am becomes sine, right? What is mod of m dash of t? It is am into omega m. Or it is also equal to am into 2 pi fm. Am into 2 pi fm. Correct? So you substitute these two things. In case of fm, what is delta f? Kf by 2 pi maximum m dash of t, that is am. Obviously, Kf am by 2 pi. In case of pm, delta f equal to Kp by 2 pi into mod of m dash of t. What is that? Am 2 pi fm. Am into 2 pi into fm. So 2 pi to pi cancel. Kp, sorry. 2 pi to pi cancel. Kp am fm. Kp am fm. So this is for single tone modulation. So what you can observe in case of phase modulation, in case of frequency modulation, it only depends upon AM, isn't it? In case of phase modulation, it depends upon AM as well as FM. So maximum frequency deviation, how it is defined? It is defined as maximum of theta of t minus omega c t. You must know this. This is very, very, very important. So theta of t minus omega c t. So let us go to the another slide. What is theta of t minus omega c t? Theta of t minus omega c t. In case of fm, what is theta of t minus omega c t? Kf integration of m of t. in case of PM, KP, M of T. Okay, so that is simple derivations only, right? Yeah, this is what you get. This is the formula, simple formulas. Okay, if it is for tone modulation, this is what you get. So in case of FM, what is delta of T? In case of PM, it is KP by AM. In case of FM, it is KF AM by 2 pi FM. Okay, so please remember, so the phase deviation delta of T, delta of theta, and frequency deviation, these are two important parameters of this angle modulation. Is it okay? They are very, very important. So you must be able to derive these two expressions, delta of theta, delta of phi. Okay, for two kinds of modulations, FM and PM. Okay, so I request not to remember these formulas, you just remember the basic definition of what is a frequency deviation, what is a phase deviation. Okay, if you remember, you can just derive them, that is not a big deal. Okay, so let us go to the phase modulation. Yeah, so here what I do here is, in case of phase modulation, what is the equation of phase modulation? Let me write, equation is S of T, S cos omega C T plus K P M of T. Isn't it? No. So what is M of T? If you take M of T equal to AM cos omega M T. Now what is S of T? Equation of PM, AC cos omega C T plus K P A M cos omega M T. Okay, so can you tell me what is KP into AM? Actually, what is that? What is KP into AM? Okay, okay, so leave it. Now here, so let us define something called beta. Is it okay? What is beta? Is nothing but it is called deviation ratio. What it is that? It's a deviation ratio. How it is defined? Delta F by omega or W. What is W? Bandwidth of message signal. Beta is nothing but deviation ratio, which is equal to delta F by W, or you can also write delta F by B. What is the B? Bandwidth of message signal. Okay, now so for tone modulation means what? Obviously M of T should be equal to some AM cos omega M T. If M of T happened to be a sinusoidal signal, this beta is known as modulation index. This is known as modulation index. Generally, beta is called deviation ratio. If M of T happened to be a sinusoidal signal, it is called as a modulation index. Okay, now, so if beta equal to delta F by FM, this is called modulation index of which modulation technique? Index of angle modulation. Angle modulation means, so the definition of beta is same for both techniques. Both means पीएम एंड एफएम। ओके, सो दिस इज डेफिनेशन ऑफ मॉड्यूलेशन इंडेक्स ऑफ एंगल मॉड्यूलेटेड सिग्नल। सो हियर एम ऑफ टी शुड बी एम कॉस ओमेगा एम टी। व्हाट इज एफएम? एफएम इज नथिंग बट मैसेज फ्रीक्वेंसी और मैसेज बैंडविड्थ। Is it okay? So delta f by fm. Please remember this. Okay. Now, so what is the modulation index formula of fm? So the formula is same whether it is fm or pm. What is the formula of modulation index? Delta f by fm. Okay. But what is delta f in case of fm? Kf am by 2 pi. Now, so what is beta now? Kf am by 2 pi fm. This is beta. Also, this is same as peak frequency deviation. So in FM, what is delta of theta? Just now we have derived. What is that? Kf am by 2 pi fm. Can you able to see it or not? Kf am by 2 pi fm. That is delta of theta. But that is also formula of beta. Or that is nothing but modulation index. Okay, so this is very, very important in case of FM frequency modulation. Okay, now in case of PM, what is beta now? Delta F by FM. What is delta F in case of PM? How much? Kp am by fm, by fm you get kp am. Okay, what is kp am? It is nothing but delta of theta. Okay, you can see in the last line kp am is nothing but delta of theta, but that is also same as beta. Beta is same as kp am, same as delta of theta. Is it okay? Right, so that is nothing but modulation index of angle modulation. So the formula is, this is the formula, it is for all techniques. All means both frequency and phase. Just find out what is delta f and divide by fm, you get beta. Okay, so one thing to be remembered is actually beta is a unitless quantity actually, because it is ratio of two numbers, both are in frequencies only, right? Obviously beta has got no units, but here what about units of delta of theta? It should be actually radians. That's why generally what we write here is delta of theta equal to beta radians. Beta has got no units actually. Okay, so you must write delta of theta equal to beta radians. Okay, don't write delta of theta equal to beta, because delta of theta has got some units whereas beta has got no units. So that's why delta of theta equal to beta radians. You must write like this. Okay, so these are very, very simple things. Now let us go to the phase modulation. S of t equal to ac cos omega c t plus kpm of t. What is m of t? I am substituting here. S of t equal to ac cos omega c t plus kp am cos omega t. But what is kp am? That is nothing but beta. Okay, so beta, write beta there. Now this is the what equation is this? Singleton phase modulation. This is a phase modulation equation if m of t happened to be a sinusoidal signal. AC cos omega c t plus beta cos omega m t. What is beta? It is called the modulation index of FM. PM, sorry, PM. What is that? KP AM. KP AM is a modulus index of PM. Is it okay, all of you? Right? Now, so can you do same thing for FM? You do it? Okay. So let us take FM equation. See, these are simple calculations. What is FM equation? What is FM equation? S of t equal to AC cos omega CT plus KF integration of m of tau d tau. Isn't it? So what is integration of m of tau d tau? We find out this. If m of t equal to am cos omega mt, what is integration of 0 to t m of tau d tau? What answer? You tell me fast. Integration this what? Am by omega m, cos becomes sine. Isn't it? Substitute this here. What do you get? Equal to AC cos omega CT plus KF AM by omega M. KF AM by omega M means 2 pi FM into sin omega MT. What is this? KF AM by 2 pi FM. What is that? In case of frequency modulation, KF AM by 2 pi FM. What is this? Modulus index of FM. This is nothing but beta FM. Obviously, what is your equation, final equation of FM equation? This is the final equation of FM. FM, if and only if, per single tone message signal. What is beta in case of FM? KF AM by 2 pi FM. Please remember this. So this is the actual formula of beta. It is for any kind of angle modulation, whether it is FM or PM. The formula is same. Delta F by FM or delta F by W actually. W is the bandwidth of the message signal. So actual beta is called deviation ratio. But if m of t is a sinusoidal signal, it is called modulation index, whose formula is delta F by FM. What is FM? Message frequency. Yeah. So these are the equations of PM and FM if and only if m of t is AM cos 2 pi FMT. What is PM? AC cos omega CT plus beta cos omega MT. FM is AC cos omega CT plus beta sin omega MT. That is the simple derivation. Any doubts as of now? Please, you can ask me. I think derivations are very, very simple. Okay. Right. So we have derived both equations. We know the generalized formula, and also we know the formula of PM and FM if m of t is a AM cos omega MT. Usually, beta is much more than 1. What is beta? Modulation index. Yeah, this is the final table. For FM, delta F by FM equal to KF AM by 2 pi FM. That is beta. That is also same as peak phase deviation. Beta is nothing but same as phase deviation. Here also, beta is equal to phase deviation. A PM, what is beta? KPAM, that is also equal to delta of theta. Same thing for FM. What is beta? KF AM by 2 pi FM. That is also same as delta of theta. But remember, K pi KP. KF, KP are some constants whose units are radians per volt. If you want in terms of hertz per volt, you just divide by 2 pi. Okay, that's clear. So generally, beta is, we take beta to be much more than 1. So suppose if beta is less than 1, much less than 1, we call it as narrow band FM. Narrow band FM. If beta is more than 1, we call it as a wide band FM. Narrow band FM means NB FM. If it is more, it is called wide band FM. Okay, just remember this. I will explain later. Right. So now this figure will give you the impact of frequency modulation. So how it happens? You take a message signal. I have taken some sine signal, sine or cos, anything so. This is a carrier. This is M of T. This is C of T. Carrier. This is S of T. Okay. Now what's happening here? So in the phase modulation, what we do? The instantaneous, this is frequency modulation. Okay. What happens here? In frequency modulation, what I've written? Omega I of t is proportional to m of t. Okay? Omega I t or f I of t. Both are okay. So the instantaneous frequency is proportional to m of t. Okay? So here, the frequency is varying. It is not same always. It is varying, right? How it is varying? Proportional to the m of t. Okay, you can observe here. M of t is increasing like this. Here also frequency is increasing. Okay, increasing. M of t is decreasing, it is going negative. Here M of t is negative, very less. What about frequency? Also less. Again M of t increasing, frequency also increasing. M of t decreasing here. Frequency also decreasing. Okay, how can we say frequency is increasing, decreasing? You observe the gap. Here, the cycles are very closely spaced. Here, the cycles are far away from each other. Frequency is different, right? They are not same frequencies. You can observe here. So here, it has got less frequency. It has got more frequency. Isn't it? Okay. Now here, we are varying the frequency of the carrier according to the message signal. If message is more, frequency also more. If message is less, frequency also less. Okay. Remember, according to the message signal, but to be specific, according to the amplitude of message signal. Please remember this. Okay, so the condition is the frequency varies according to the amplitude of message signal. People will get confused here actually. What they think is, so the frequency of the carrier varies according to the frequency of message signal. No. The frequency of the carrier varies according to the amplitude of the message signal only. Okay? This is about FM waveform. What is constant? Amplitude. Amplitude is constant. It is not changing. Here AC only. If this is AC, it is also AC. Frequency is varying according to the message signal. That's it. Okay. Now, what about phase modulation? I have written already So in phase modulation, omega it is proportional to what? M dash of t. This is for phase modulation. Okay. Now, so to explain both, I have taken this diagram. So
ఇదే పిక్ పెట్టు దీని నలుగురు ఉన్నారు శ్రీకాంత్ గాంధీ యాది
గాంధీ ఓకే నౌ దిస్ ఇస్ సిఆర్టీ క్యారియర్ దిస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ అన్ మాడ్యులేటెడ్ క్యారియర్ హియర్ సో ఐ హావ్ టేకెన్ ఎంఆర్టీ ఓకే So, what happened here? Suppose, what is this? What is the waveform this? This is a sine waveform. Okay? This waveform is sine waveform. Okay? In FM, what happens? In FM, what happens? The frequency will be proportional to m of t. Okay, so let us take m of t sine. In FM, so how the frequency is varying according to the sine theta. Okay, you can see here. So what happened here? M of t is here is minimum. It is zero actually. Okay, this is the frequency. At this point, m of t is in the peak. M of t is maximum. That's why frequency is also maximum. M of t decreasing, here also frequency decreasing. Here M of t is minimum, frequency also minimum. Again M of t maximum, frequency maximum. M of t minimum, frequency minimum. Okay, so M of t increasing up to this point. Frequency also increasing up to this point. From this point, M of t decreasing. Up to this point. M of t also decreasing in this region. Again increasing, decreasing. Okay, clear? Right? So that is with respect to okay. Now what about PM? What about PM? It is proportional to the derivative of M of t, not M of t. So this dashed line is a M dash of t. If this is sine waveform, what is derivative of sine? Cos. Now this is now M dash of t. Okay, now in FM, what happened? So the frequency varies according to m dash of t. This is m dash of t. This is m of t. Okay, now you can see here, it is maximum here. Frequency also maximum. It is decreasing. Here also decreasing. Here it is maximum. Here also frequency maximum. Here it is minimum. Here also frequency minimum. Here it is maximum. Here is frequency maximum. Okay, so you can very clearly see the difference. In case of FM waveform, the frequency varies according to m of t, according to amplitude of m of t. In PM, it varies according to the amplitude of m dash of t. Okay, so you have taken both waveforms. So if m of t happen to be a sine theta, m dash of t is cos theta. Is it okay? So that is about, this is a MATLAB simulation. Okay, now this is a phase modulation simulation. This is a explained. Yeah, you can clearly see here, this is a FM waveform, this is a PM waveform. They look alike. Okay, they look similar. Okay, that's why we say that they are very closely related. Is it okay? They are very much similar. Yeah, for both FM and PM, angle of is constant. You can see very clearly. The amplitude is constant. The only thing is we are changing the frequencies according to M of t or M dash of t. Okay? They are very closely related. You can see these two figures. They have very little difference. Okay? So since they are very closely related, we don't study them separately. Okay, there is no point in studying them separately because they are exactly same. There are only some minor variations. That's why we study only about FM. We concentrate only on FM because both are exactly similar. So there is no point in studying both things separately. If there are any differences, I will tell you later. But as of now, we study only about FM. We concentrate only on FM. Okay, we study some properties of FM. So what is the property? The transmission power. Okay. So we are transmitting S of T, correct? So S of T, they are having what? Same amplitude. What amplitude of the signal? AC. For FM. For PM, what amplitude? AC. You can see very clearly. So everything is inside the cos. This is everything is inside the cos parenthesis, something like this. Cos of some theta. What is theta? This is theta. Everything is inside the cos, not outside the cos. The only thing that is outside the cos is what? AC. Here also, everything is inside a cos term. The only thing outside is AC. Obviously, so what is the transmission power? AC square by 2. It does not depend upon anything. AP, KF, no. It depends only upon the amplitude of the carrier. AC is the amplitude of the carrier. Obviously, power will be the amplitude square by 2, AC square by 2. But what is the transmission power of AM? We'll tell the answer. What? The transmission power of AM, that is PC into, we have derived this, 1 plus mu square by 2 for amplitude modulation. So the transmission power of AM depends upon its modulation index, whereas for angle modulation, it does not depend upon modulation index. It is always same, that is AC square by 2. Okay, this is one of the advantages. Obviously, both FM and PM are non-linear in nature because they do not satisfy superposition principle. Yeah, as I told you, if beta is much less than 1, we call narrowband FM. If beta is more than 1, it's called wideband FM. So in our course, we only study about wideband FM, which means beta should be more than 1. Okay, so narrowband FM is it is not that important. But remember, if beta is much less than 1, it is called narrow band FM. Okay. So any doubts as of now, please, you can ask me. Any kind of doubts, you can also message me at least. Now, so let us study the spectrum of FM signal. See, as I told you just now, we'll study the properties only for FM. You can also assume that same thing for PM. Okay, because they're very much closely related. That's why we don't study them separately. We study only about FM. We concentrate only on FM. Okay. So this is the FM signal. Please remember, this is FM signal if M of T is a single tone signal. So since FM is non-linear, exact spectrum calculations would be difficult because we cannot apply Fourier transform directly. But so in case of AM, what have we done? If you remember properly, we have taken S of T equal to AC cos. What is AM equation? AC into 1 plus mu cos omega m t into cos omega ct. Since it was linear, we could able to find out S of f, and we could able to draw the spectrum. This for AM. But FM is non-linear. Okay, so it is not so easy to calculate the Fourier transform because everything is inside the cos. Okay, everything is inside the cos. So we'll study by using a complex representation of a passband signal. Okay, so here I am not deriving all these things here. I'll write directly. This is one you must remember. There is no other way. Okay, it is also FM equation. This is called complex representation of passband signal. So there is a derivation, but I am not going with the derivation. You just remember this. What is this? AC, open the bracket. AC, close the bracket. Summation n equal to minus infinity plus infinity jn beta cos 2 pi fc plus n fm t. What is jn beta is called? It is called Bessel function. What is called? Bessel function. Okay. So this j n of beta. What is n? What is beta? N is called order. What is beta? Is a modulation index. Okay. Now how j n beta is defined? It is like this. 1 by 2 pi minus pi to pi e power j beta sin x minus n x dx. Okay. So here I want to tell you, don't worry about this j n beta. There is a table. From table you get these values. Bessel function table is there. From table you can get the values of j n beta. Okay, don't worry about j n beta. That is called Bessel function of first kind. You remember this equation. What is that? AC summation is equal to minus to plus infinity j n beta cos 2 pi fc plus n fm t. Okay. Otherwise, in the simplest form, you can also write this as, so forget about AC, summation n equal to minus to plus infinity j n beta cos omega c plus n omega m t. Simplest form. That is simplest form. Omega c plus n omega m t, cos of omega c plus n omega m of t. Okay. Remember this, that's it. If you want to write, you can write AC here. N varies from minus to plus infinity. This is a Bessel coefficient whose values can be found out from table. Don't worry about this j n beta. Okay, only think about this cos of omega c plus n omega m into t. Okay. Now, so let us study about this Bessel. This is a plot of Bessel function of first kind. Okay. So this x axis is n. N is called order. Okay. So suppose you observe here, if beta equal to 1, beta equal to 1, this is the JN beta, this is JN beta. Okay, so if beta equal to 2, this is J2 beta. Sorry, if beta equal to 1, this is JN1. If beta equal to 2, this is JN2. Beta equal to 3, this is JN3. This is JN4, so on so on. So what you can observe? What you can observe? If beta, let us say beta equal to 1, it is decreasing. As n increases, as n increases, Jn beta is decreasing for beta equal to 1. Okay, for beta equal to, so suppose what happens if n equal to 0, it is increasing, increasing. From this point, again it is decreasing. This third wave, increasing after some time, it is also decreasing. Okay, decreasing, decreasing. Okay, they have some, they have got some oscillations, increasing, decreasing, increasing, decreasing. But so broadly, I can say that they are decreasing. Okay, they should decreasing like this. And also, it is decreasing like this. Okay, decreasing, decreasing, decreasing. Okay, as n increases, J beta decreases. This is a broadly, but they have got oscillations. Okay, this is very clear, right? The simplest term, I can say broadly, I can say they are decreasing, but not exactly. There are some variations or oscillations. It is also one more graph, yeah, but this is versus beta versus Jn beta. You assume x to be equal to beta, x equal to beta. Okay, this is one more waveform. So what observation? So this is J1 beta. This is J0 beta. This is J1 beta. This is J2 beta. J3 beta. J4, J5, something like that. Okay, so this graph is beta versus JN beta. But this graph is what? N versus JN beta. Okay, you try to observe the differences. Okay. So let us study some properties of Bessel function. Okay. So what are the properties? Yeah, this is very, very important. Jn beta equal to minus 1 power n j minus n beta for all n. Okay, what is that? Please be careful here. This property is very, very important. Jn beta is equal to, is also equal to minus 1 whole power n j minus n beta. Suppose if n equal to 1, 1 means odd number. What you can say? J1 beta equal to minus 1, n equal to 1, no, minus 1, minus j minus 1 beta. Please be careful. If n equal to 2, even, what happens? J 2 beta equal to minus 1 whole square j minus 2 beta. Correct? What is minus 1 whole square? What is minus 1 whole square? 1. So which means J2 beta equal to J minus 2 beta. This is for n even. Okay, can you tell me what is J3 beta will be equal to? Obviously, J3 beta will be equal to minus J minus 3 beta. what about J for beta equal to? J for beta means n equal to 4, that is even number. J for beta equal to J minus 4 beta. Like this. Okay, that is very, very important. Why? What about n? Is it, it can be minus? Yes. N can be minus. Why? Because in this expression, n varies from where to where? Minus infinity to plus infinity. So the limits of n are plus or minus infinity. N belongs to minus infinity, also plus infinity. Okay. But, so if you know one value of j, if you know j for beta, that is same as j minus 4 beta. So if you know j3 beta, you can also find out j minus 3 beta just by keeping minus. Okay. So that is one of the important properties of Bessel function. They are called Bessel function of first kind. So for small values of beta, we have. But if beta is very, very small, what it is called as? What it is called as? Anyone? If beta is very, very small, if beta is less than 1, what is it called? Anyone? What it is called? If beta is less than 1, what it is called? It's called narrow band effect. Is it okay? It's called narrow band effect. In case of narrow band effect, actually, J naught beta is approximately equal to 1. J1 beta is approximately equal to beta by 2. Jn beta is approximately equal to 0 when n is more than 2. Okay. Yeah, you can observe here. Here, x is nothing but beta. Is it okay? X is nothing but beta. If beta is very, very small, means less than 1. If beta is less than 1, much, much less than 1, what is j not beta in this region? It is 1. Okay, what about J1 beta? It is having some value. Okay, what about J2 beta? Something like J3 beta. What is the J3 beta before, I mean, when beta is less than 1? It is 0. J4, 0. J, everything is 0. Okay, that's why I have written here very clearly. This is the logic. If n is more than 2 or n is greater than or equal to, Jn beta is almost 0. This is the property of Bessel function also. Please remember, it is true if and only if beta is very, very small. Small means less than 1. You must know this property. Very, very, very important. Okay? And one more thing. Summation n equal to minus to plus infinity, Jn square beta equal to 1. Okay, I'll write here. This is also one of the important property. Sum of n equal to minus 2 plus infinity j n square beta equal to 1. Sum of squares of all Bessel coefficients is equal to 1. Which means what? So if I take some values of n. Okay, if you, let us take, what do you write? Suppose I'll start from minus 2. J minus 2 square beta. J minus 2 square beta. Plus J minus 1 square beta. Plus so on, so on, so on. All things are equal to 1. If you add squares of the Bessel coefficient, it is equal to 1. This is very, very important. Make a point. I'm keeping here. This is also one of the important properties of Bessel coefficient or function. As I told you just now, as n increases, Jn decreases for a fixed beta. Okay, it is some kind of approximation. if n increases, Jn beta decreases by keeping beta constant. Okay. Now, so to find out the spectrum, what we do? Now we can take the Fourier transform. What have you written? I have written S of t equal to AC summation n equal to minus 2 plus infinity Jn beta. So I have written the FM equation like this, Jn beta. Next, what I have written? Cos omega c plus n omega m t. So s is a constant, this is also Bessel coefficient. So only thing is, we have to take the Fourier transform to this term. You can take very easily, no problem. And one more thing is, Fourier transform obeys a linearity property. Okay, so what is the Fourier transform of cos omega ct plus n omega mt? Can you tell me? You find out. What is the Fourier transform of cos omega ct plus n omega mt? Anybody? What is the Fourier transform? I am writing in terms of omega. Pi into delta of omega plus omega c plus n omega m plus, what is next, plus delta of omega minus omega c minus n omega m. Do you agree with me? Is it a sum in terms of f? In terms of f, it is okay. So AC is there now. S is there, no? Yeah, okay. Now what about this term now? So what about of S of F now? In terms of F, let me write this. Otherwise, in terms of F, what do you write? 1 by 2 delta of F plus FC plus NF. This is one term, plus delta of F minus FC minus NF. But I want to find out Fourier transform of what term? AC summation n equal to minus 2 plus infinity Jn beta into cos term. I am not writing what is this, because for this we have taken Fourier transform. So here the Fourier transform of S, what property? Linearity property, which means what you can write? You can write now the spectrum. You can write AC by 2 summation n equal to minus 2 plus infinity. Summation remains summation only because it is obeying linearity property Jn beta. Now, what to write now? Jn beta. Now, delta. Delta of F plus FC plus NFM, this is one term, plus delta of F minus FC minus NFM. The upshot is, now this is the final spectrum of FM signal. Right, so any doubts? Okay, right. Thank you, we stop here.